Hey everyone, it's Kristen from KBecca, and today we're going to be making a super quick and easy card by combining the sketch feature of the Silhouette Cameo with watercoloring. First, we need to make our card design. So I've got the Silhouette Studio software open here, and I'll go over and choose the Shape Drawing tool from the left menu, then choose the Draw a Rectangle option, and click and drag on the artboard to make a rectangle. The size doesn't matter at this point since we'll be customizing this in the next step. Once the rectangle is made, click on it to select it, then go over to the far right menu and open the Transform panel. Once that's open, click the tab in the window with the diagonal arrows icon to open the Scale window. It's the second tab from the left. Next, down in the Specify Dimensions area, we want to make sure that the little lock icon is unlocked so we can set the width and height independently of each other. I'm making an A2 size vertical card, which is 4.25 inches wide by 5.5 inches tall when folded. And I want this rectangle, which will be the card front, to be a little bit smaller than the card base size. So I'll set the width to 4 inches and the height to 5.25 inches and click the Apply button to apply the changes. I'll just click and drag the rectangle way up into the top left corner of the artboard so I won't waste paper when I cut the piece later. Okay, now we'll create the design on the rectangle card front, and to do that, I'll be using a couple of different sketch files. First, I'll open the Sketch Laurel Wreath, select it, and press Ctrl or Command plus C on my keyboard to copy it. Then I'll click over to the file that has our rectangle card front and press Ctrl or Command plus V to paste the wreath. Then I'll just drag it up inside the rectangle. I'm happy with the default size of the wreath, so I won't need to resize it. Next, I want to center the wreath on the card front, so I'll click and drag to select both the rectangle and the wreath, and then I'll go over to the far right menu and open the Transform panel again. In the Align area, I'll first click to center align the two shapes horizontally, and then I'll click to align them vertically. Okay, now the wreath is perfectly centered on the card front. Next, I'll open a set of Hello themed sentiment sketch files. I need to ungroup them to get the individual sentiment that I want to use, so I'll click to select the group. Then I'll go up to the top menu and choose Object, then Ungroup to ungroup the sentiments. When I do this, you'll see a box appear around each individual sentiment. For our card, we'll be using the Hello Friend sentiment, so I'll click on it to select it, then press Ctrl or Command plus C on my keyboard to copy it, and click back over to the file with the card design and press Ctrl or Command plus V to paste the sentiment into the file. At its default size, the sentiment is going to be too large for our card, so I'll click on one of the corner handles and drag it inward to scale the sentiment down. When I drag it inside the wreath, it's still a little bit too large, so I'll click and drag on one of the corner handles again to resize it until it fits well inside the wreath. I need to center the sentiment, so we'll repeat the same process that we went through earlier when we centered the wreath on the card front, but this time in the Transform panel, I'm just going to center the sentiment horizontally. Then I'll click on the artboard to deselect everything and click on the sentiment to select it and use the up and down arrows on my keyboard to nudge it to where I think it looks good vertically inside the wreath. Now our card design is basically finished, so I want to save the file to my computer so I'll be able to use the design again whenever I want. You could also save it to your library here. We have one more thing to do before we click the Send tab. First, click to select the rectangle. Then go over to the far right menu and open the Line Style panel and click on the tab in the panel with the colored lines to open the Line Fill Color window. Choose a color that's not red for the line color on the rectangle. I just chose a shade of blue. You'll see why we do this in the next step. I'll do a quick save of the file to save the changes, and then I'll go over and click the Send tab. Next, click the Line tab from within the Send window to open the Cut by Line Color window. You'll see two rows in this area. One has a blue square, and this represents the rectangle card front, and the other is a red square, and this represents the sketch designs. We changed the line color on the rectangle earlier, so we'll be able to cut and sketch the shape separately when we send the file to the machine. Cutting by color has become one of my favorite features of the Silhouette Studio software because it makes the cutting and sketching process much more efficient, especially if you have a Cameo, which has a dual tool holder. On the far left side of the row with the blue square, I'll click on the right circle in the tool number column to choose the blue tool, aka the right tool holder on the Silhouette Cameo. You can't use an auto blade in the right tool holder, so if that's the only type of blade that you have, you'll want to set this row up for the left tool holder. But I have a ratchet blade, so I'll use that in the right tool holder to cut the rectangle card front. I'll leave all of the other options in the row as is, but I do want to change the cut settings for the paper that I'll be using. You want to use a watercolor-friendly paper for this, and I'm using Strathmore Bristol Smooth Paper. So I'll bump the blade depth up to 6. Sometimes I need a 7 or 8, it depends on how dull my blade is. I'll increase the force to 33 and do 2 passes to make sure the paper cuts the whole way through. Next, I'll go up to the row with the red square, and I'll go to the action column on the far right and change that to sketch. I'll leave all of the options as is, including the settings down below. If you have a machine with only one tool holder, you can use the pause button to add a pause between the rows so you can switch out the tools in the tool holder as the machine is working. I need to set up my machine before I send this file to it, so I'll see you over there. Okay, I'm over at the Cameo, and the first thing I need to do is to remove the auto blade from the left tool holder. I'll adjust the ratchet blade to the correct depth, and then I'll place it into the right tool holder, the one with the little blue circle on it, and push the tab on the holder until it clicks to lock the blade in place. Then I'll get out my pen holder, which is the Chomas Creations marker holder. I'll place that into the left tool slot and click the tab to lock it in place. For this project, we need to make sure that we're using a pen or marker with a water-resistant or waterproof ink, and I'll be using one of these Sharpie Precision ultra-fine point markers. I just want to give you a heads up that some of the Sharpie markers and pens that I have aren't water-resistant and will run if used with a water-based medium, but these work beautifully with watercolors. I just let the ink sit for a couple of minutes to make sure that it's completely dry after it's on paper, and I haven't had any problems. I also love the range of colors that's included in this set. I'm going to be using shades of blue in my card instead of the traditional green when I watercolor the leaves on the wreath, so I'll use the navy blue marker from the set. I'll slide a popsicle stick under the sketch tool holder, and then I'll place the marker into the holder until it just barely touches the popsicle stick. This is the perfect little tool for making sure that your pens and markers are at the right height for sketching. I'll tighten the adjustment screw on the side of the holder until the marker is held firmly in place, and then I'll remove the popsicle stick. Next, I'll load my paper onto a mat, and as I mentioned earlier, I'm using Strathmore Bristol Smooth Paper for this, and I'll load the mat into the machine and go over to the computer and click the send button in Silhouette Studio to send the file to the machine. When the machine is finished, I'll unload the mat and remove the marker from the tool holder so I can put the cap back on before it has a chance to start to dry out. I'll allow a couple of minutes for the ink to dry completely on the paper before I start watercoloring. You can remove the card from the mat at this point, but I prefer to leave it on the mat because the adhesive on the mat helps prevent the paper from warping or buckling while I'm watercoloring. The watercolors that I'll be using for this project are the Prima Decadent Pies, and I've spritzed the paints a few times with a spritzer bottle to allow them to soften and activate. I've also got a paper towel here to absorb excess water as needed from the brush, and today I'm just using one jar of water since it's a small project. Typically, I'd have 2 jars, one for clean water and one to rinse off my brush. I'll be using a size 5 round brush for this project. This is a swatch chart that I made a while back for this watercolor set, so you can see all of the beautiful colors that you can make with just the 12 paints in the set. I'll be using colors in the range of the blues and blue-greens for this card. The first color that we'll be using is the blue here, which is a mix of colors 28 and 36 from the set. I'll wet my brush and mix those 2 colors together to make the final shade, and then I'll paint about every other leaf or so on the wreath in this shade of blue. My watercolor style tends to be very loose, so I'm not looking to stay inside the lines of the leaves as I'm painting. I actually want the watercolor to go outside the lines here and there because that's the look that I'm going for. But if you prefer a neater, more stay inside the lines approach, you can certainly do that. I'll reload the brush with watercolor and/or water as needed as I work my way around the wreath. After I'm finished painting with the first color, I'll mix my next color, which is a mix of paint colors 26 and 35 from the set. After that's mixed, I'll paint the remaining leaves on the wreath with it. Now I want to add some depth and dimension to the watercolor, so next I'll mix this deep aqua shade, which is a mix of colors 33 and 36 from the set. And I'll paint this onto the leaves that I painted with the first color that I used earlier to add some color variation and depth. You can paint on whichever leaves you'd like though, and you can use more colors that I'm using for this project as well. For example, I could have added some plum shades or grays or even some greens and yellows, but I wanted a more tone-on-tone look for the wreath. The final color that I'm using is just straight paint color 35 from the set, which is a nice deep indigo blue. After I'm finished with that color, I'll come back in here and there to add some more color to certain leaves, and then I came in on some of the leaves with the white pearlescent paint from the set to add a little bit of shimmer. You can't really see the shimmer on video, but it's really nice in person when the paint is dry. When I'm finished painting, I'll allow the paint to dry completely, which didn't take more than a few minutes or so since we didn't use a whole lot of paint or water for this project. After the paint is dry, I'll remove everything from the mat and I'll add some dimensional foam tape to the back of the piece to give it a little bit of dimension when I adhere it to my card base. Finally, I'll add some white Blizzard Glitter Nouveau drops around the wreath to create little berry type elements and to give the card a little bit of extra dimension and sparkle. There are so many creative possibilities when you combine sketch and watercolor using your digital cutting machine. You can find a full list of supplies used for this project in the description area below or in the area below the video if you're watching on kbecca.com. I hope that you enjoyed this video, and if you'd like to see more sketch and watercolor projects, please give the video a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching, and I hope you'll tune in again soon.